you can see this system that we are having n number of buses, and there are generator installed at the various buses. Okay, we have I think a whiteboard is also shown to you. So in this fault calculation system, we need to apply the approach of ZBus, but the procedure is almost same. Only thing is that here we do not need to determine the Thevenin equivalent, but directly we can have with us the ZBus. In fact, is the ZBus in fact is having the diagonal and off diagonal elements, driving point self impedances and the transfer impedances. The ZBus diagonal elements are, so if I am having ZBus, right, so Z11, Z12, Z1n, 21, 22, 2n, N1, N2, NN. So N into N system is there. So in ZBus N into N system, these are the diagonal and off diagonal elements, which means that the self impedances are given by the diagonal, which gives the self impedances, which represent the Thevenin equivalent of the power system. When we look into the power system from the particular value of the bus, for example, if I have ZKK, right, so ZKK is the Thevenin equivalent of the network. If I look into the network from the kth bus, okay, so I write here ZKK is the Thevenin equivalent impedance of the network when looking from kth bus. So this is the important feature of the ZBus. Any diagonal impedance is having this property. So this property is well applied in fault calculations. Now just look at this 3.33. You can see that we have been given the pre-fault bus voltages V bus naught. Okay, so V1, V2, Vk and Vn, n into 1. So applying the 0, V1 0, V2 0, Vk 0, Vn 0. This is pre-fault. So pre-fault bus voltages can be obtained from the load flow analysis, which is the normal conditions analysis of the power system. Now, in order to obtain the voltages which happens to be in the system after the occurrence of fault, we have this equation 3.34. V bus F is equal to V bus naught plus delta V. Okay, so it means after the occurrence of fault, the pre-fault bus voltages are modified with this change delta V. So V bus F is equal to V bus naught plus delta V. So why this change? This change is due to the occurrence of the fault. Now how to determine this change? This change is equal to the change in the voltages which is occurring in all the buses. You can see this figure 3.35. Delta V is equal to delta V1, delta V2, delta Vn. Now we apply the Thevenin equivalent representation. For Thevenin equivalent representation, all the generators are short-circuited. They are replaced by their transient or subtransient reactances. And K is the bus where fault has been occurred. So Thevenin voltage is applied at the kth bus in series with the fault impedance Zf in such a way that fault current flows from the kth bus towards the ground. So you can look at this figure 3.18, which gives the Thevenin, passive Thevenin impedance network, right? So what we have done, the generators are replaced by their transient or subtransient reactances. So this is XD1 dash, transient reactance of generator number one, XD2 dash, transient reactance of generator number two, and this is ZF fault impedance plus minus. This is due to the fact that we apply the Thevenin, E Thevenin, which is equal to VK naught. So E Thevenin is equal to VK naught because the fault has been occurred at the kth bus. We have applied it here at the kth bus because the faulty bus is kth bus is a faulty bus. Say the faulty bus is the bus number two, then we have to apply the same thing at the second bus. It will be V2 naught in series with ZF, okay? And rest all buses reactances will be replaced by their transient reactances. Now it means, just see this equation number 3.38. When we have the network of passive elements and only one active element is installed at the kth bus, it means the current is injected only at the kth bus, which is in the negative direction. So this gives me equation 3.38 gives me the what it gives, that the vector of injected bus currents. So you can see that only at the kth bus we have injected the current in the negative direction, because this is the same as a fault current which is going downwards, right? So from here I obtain the value of change in the voltage. Let me do it on the whiteboard. How I have done it? So delta V is obtained as Z bus into I bus. This is the property of the interconnected network, that V bus is given by Z bus I bus. Here in this situation, we have the V bus which is equal to delta V. So if I apply here delta V is equal, delta, what is delta V? Delta V1, delta V2, delta Vk, and delta Vn. Okay. Now multiplied with the Z bus, Z11, Z12, Z1k, Z1n, 21, 2n, k1, k2, kk, kn, n1, n2, nk, nn. So this is n into n z bus matrix multiplied by zero, zero, minus IF, zero. The current vector is having all the values zero except the kth element. This is important. So kth element current value is minus IF. Why? Because we have only one active source in this network. You can see this figure 3.18. We are having only one source, which is having VK node. That's why current is flowing outwards. So injected current is minus IF. Right. So here, from here, I determine the value of delta V1. So you can determine delta V1 by solving this Z11 into 0, Z12 into 0, but it is minus Z1K into IF. Similarly, delta V2 is obtained as follows, minus Z2K into IF. Delta VK is obtained as minus ZKK into IF. So delta Vn is obtained as Z minus ZnK into IF. Okay. Now once we have obtained the value of change in the voltages, right? So I can simply add up with the pre-fault bus voltage. Kehne ka matlab ye hai ki how to obtain V1F. It is V1 naught plus delta V1, so Z1K IF. So Z1K IF. V2F kis tarah aayega? V2 naught minus Z2K IF. VKF is VK naught minus ZKK IF. VNF is equal to VN naught Z minus ZNK into IF. So this is the post fault bus voltages which has been obtained. Now if you look at this network of the Thevenin representation, this value is equal to this value is equal to ZF IF. ZF IF. Okay. The post fault voltage at the kth bus is ZF into IF. If ZF zero hai, it is zero simply. So from here I calculate the value of the fault current. So by using this, I can write here VK naught minus ZKK IF is equal to ZF IF. ठीक है, so VK naught की value मेरे को लगी है ZKK plus ZF into IF. Which simply means that fault current is equal to VK naught by ZKK plus ZF. Right? So this relation is valid and it matches with the previous relation which we have obtained from the Thevenin theorem. What we have obtained? E Thevenin divided by Z Thevenin plus ZF. ठीक है, सो ई थेवेनिन किदे बराबर है वीके नॉट दे, जेड थेवेनिन किदे बराबर है जेड के के दे. सो इत्थे सानू जेड थेवेनिन बार बार कैलकुलेट करने की लोड़ नहीं है. द जेड बस विच वी ऑबटेन वंस, एक बार जो आप जेड बस कैलकुलेट कर लांगे तो एवरी एलीमेंट गिव्स मी द एवरी डायगनल एलीमेंट गिव्स मी द थेवेनिन इम्पीडेंस इफ आई लुक इनटू द नेटवर्क फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर बस। इहदा मतलब यह है कि जे फॉल्ट फस्ट बस से है ठीक है लैट्स से माई फॉल्ट इज एट द बस नंबर वन तो जैड थेवेनिन कि बराबर है जैड वन वन के बराबर है जे फॉल्ट हैगा बस नंबर टू ते तो फॉल्ट इज एट द बस नंबर टू दैन वट हैपन्स जैड थेवेनिन इज इक्वल टू जैड टू टू। सिमिलरली इफ द फॉल्ट इज एट द बस नंबर थ्री दैन द फॉल्ट दैन द थेवेनिन इंपीडेंस इज इक्वल टू जैड थ्री थ्री। Similarly, here we have the fault at the kth bus. That's why we have used the Thevenin impedance as ZKK. Now, once we have determined the fault impedance, then we can easily obtain the fault voltages at each and every bus. You can look at this whiteboard. Right, so V1F is equal to V1 naught minus Z1K IF. IF is calculated from here. V1 naught minus Z1K VK naught divided by ZKK plus ZF ठीक है so V1 naught minus Z1K into VK naught divided by ZKK plus ZF. Similarly, if I want to calculate V2F एक दे बराबर आ जाएगा वी टू नॉट माइनस जेड टू के वी के नॉट बाय जेड के प्लस जेड एफ। सिमिलरली आई कैन ऑब्टेन द वी के नॉट जेड के वी के नॉट ZKK plus ZF in general VIF is equal to VI naught minus ZIK VK naught ZKK plus ZF for I is equal to 1 to up to n. K is the faulty bus. Right. So this formula is important for us. Only this formula is important. One important formula which can solve all my purposes is this. Okay. VIF is equal to VI naught minus ZIK VK naught divided by ZKK plus ZF. Once I have obtained the V fault value of the voltages I have obtained at all the system buses, then you can look at this equation number 3.48. This gives me the branch currents, current flowing in the branches from the ith bus to the jth bus with the branch impedance as Zij. So IIJF is equal to VIF minus VJF divided by ZIJ. So 1 over ZIJ is equal to YIJ, which is so YIJ VIF minus VJF. Now this gives the pre-fault generator current can be obtained from this by referring figure. We can obtain the pre-fault current And we have got this EGI dash is equal to VI naught plus JXGI IGI. So from here I have calculated the generator current which the generator is supplying after the faulty conditions. So this is the current which is supplied by the generator. 3.51 gives me the generator current. Okay. So similarly, I can also obtain the motor currents. So in the nutshell, what we can say that number one, we have to obtain the fault current by applying the formula. IF is equal to VK naught by ZKK plus ZF. After the fault current is evaluated, we calculated the post fault bus voltages. Bus voltages jehdiyan hagiyan fault point to baad post fault bus voltages, theek hai, after the crest of fault, what is the post fault bus voltages? Number 3, we calculate the branch currents, and number 4, what is the current which is given by the generators, by the active components which are there in the fault, in the faulty circuit. So this is all about in this class. In the next class, we will do the algorithm part, that what is the algorithm which is used to solve this fault analysis through ZBus. And second thing which we will cover up is that how ZBus is obtained. So what are the various methods by which ZBus can be obtained? We will cover some methods. One is from the inverse, and second is from the building algorithm method for the ZBus. So this is